What is up, you guys? Okay, I'm gonna play a little intro video for you. Well, you can't tell by the way I use my walk. I'm a woman's man, no time to talk. Using love, been me walk, been kicked around since I was born. But that was all right, I'm okay, and you may love the other way. Okay.
Yeah.
That was too much fun.
Yeah, baby.
That's what we're trying to do. So I think maybe we'll call our little talk staying alive. No, I'm just kidding. Maybe. Anyway.
Yeah.
So we're here today with, I'm Alie Valerio, and this is...
I am Harold Fletcher. What's happening?
What's up, you guys? And we are both experts in health and fitness fields. I do online health and fitness coaching, in-person personal training, nutrition, and mindset coaching. And then we have Dr. Fletcher over here. What do you do, sir?
You just want to make me a doctor.
I do. You're like a doctor.
Yes. Well, since you want to put it that way, and yes, I specialize in functional training and movement, of course, and also restorative and rehabilitative with bodies and so forth, and also classically trained in Pilates and nutrition. So if you have any fitness or wellness issues or concerns or questions, then I'm the man you want to see. Yes, Dr. Fletcher's my name, and I'm glad to be of service here, yeah.
All right, guys, so today we wanted to bring you some health and wellness tips to keep you COVID free in this crazy era that we're having right now. So Fletch, what are tips that you are telling your clients right now to help them stay into the best shape and so that they don't get sick?
Well, the main thing is making sure that the environment where they're staying is very low stress. You know, you want to make sure you want to be mindful of the music that you're playing in the background is not stressing the body. What you're actually watching visually can also cause undue stress. You just don't know. Like a lot of drama, action, thriller, like sad stuff. I'm getting into my sad stuff, like TV series and Netflix things. Be very aware of those things because you're sitting. You're not moving. You're not getting kind of released. So what's happening is it's really influencing the body in such a way that you're not even aware of. So you want to be mindful of your living situation. If you're living with someone else or coexisting with someone else, then you definitely want to be mindful of the music and what you're watching because it will influence the way you think and how you see the person you're living with or who you're sharing space with. So be very aware of that. Two, make sure you're eating really healthy, drinking lots of water. You put nothing but really good foods in the body and healthy things. You don't want to eat a lot of things that are going to give you, make you sluggish and like heavy carbs, complex carbs. Also, too, if you're not careful, you're sitting around, you're not moving, you're eating these things, can also cause a psychological situation where you start to get a little down on yourself, a little depressed. Energy level is kind of low. You're not really vibrating where you want and should be vibrating in life. So you want to be aware of your nutritional value and what you're doing with your food. And most importantly, three, getting the body to move, exercising, going for a walk, stretching. Take your time out to stretch, meditation, prayer, whatever you do to get yourself centered, things like that. So you want to definitely incorporate those three main things because then that will help everything else that's going on with the COVID and how you process and deal with what's going on in this historical time that we're in. So. Yeah,
you said the first thing that you said was your environment. So making sure that your environment is a healthy space that's stress-free, not staying up late watching crazy movies that are gonna like stress you out. Even watching the news a lot, right, is stressful.
The news. Oh my God, don't even do that.
I know. Like, the second thing,
don't do it.
What?
The second thing I said, be savvy about what's going on, but don't sit back watching news all day.
Absolutely. The second thing you said was nutrition, right? Mm-hmm. You're putting like healthy food into your body and you're not snacking all day because that can, you're right, like sugar and carbs can lead to depression, even alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third thing that I heard you say was move, right? Do a little bit of movement every day, even if it's like yoga or stretching. Yeah, 100%. I think those are great tips. Another thing I'd like to add to that is that sleep is extremely crucial in this time. This is actually the perfect opportunity for all of us to really hone down on our daily like routines that we're doing, like what time we go to bed, what time we're waking up, what our morning routine is, what our evening routine is, and mm-hmm. setting up our days so that it's exactly like we're going to work, except we're working from our home. Mm-hmm. So making sure that you're planning.
We're working on ourselves.
Exactly. Well, that we're right. That's what we'll get into too, is like, this is the perfect time to work on yourself. So the first mm-hmm. thing is make sure you're getting enough sleep. If you're not sleepy enough, it raises your cortisol levels. Cortisol is a stress hormone that makes you hold on to fat. So make sure that you're balancing that with sleep. The second thing I definitely want to add is vitamin D. Vitamin D is really important, especially for immunity. So luckily, I mean, we live in Southern California, right? We can go outside. We can go get the sun. Thank God. But most people are deficient.
Those people walk around a block, man. You know? Yeah. Just, you know, what's a good way to do? Another thing that's really good for sun, getting sun, is just like finding a spot that you can stand outside and face the sun, right? Close your eyes and let the sunlight penetrate through your eyelids. And what that does for the brain is it helps the brain to, one, be stimulated and put it in such a happy place, good mood. But what's happening is it's releasing serotonin levels, high doses of serotonin to the brain when you do that. So when you face the sunlight and you close your eyelids, and the eyelids are triggered by the sunlight, they give you that nice release of serotonin, that happy, happy, happy hormone that we all love to tap into to really change your mood and bring you back to another place. So that's another nice way of getting out there, getting some vitamin D, but really taking advantage of the sunlight as well.
I love that. Make sure you guys are wearing sunscreen though. I'm not trying to get too much vitamin C. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Even if you are dark skin,
you don't want to get cancer. So make sure you guys are wearing sunscreen. Yeah. But yeah, 100%. Sun is super crucial. And if you're not in a place right now that has a lot of sun, make sure you're taking a vitamin D supplement and do research as to where you're getting it from. I personally use a brand called Shackley. I don't know if you use a specific brand, Fletch, or if you take vitamin D.
I get a lot of my vitamins and minerals from like supplements that I use off natural and plant ingredients.
Yeah.
And I normally shop at like holistic stores, Rainbow Acres being one, Arrow One for like choice ingredients. But those are my two go-tos for nutritional supplements and so forth. But like, I don't take a direct vitamin D supplement. I take powders of things, a combination like hemp and things like maca and things like golden seal, things like, you know, Korean ginseng and so on, collagen powders, you know, fractionated coconut oil, which is MCT oils. So yeah, there's a combination of a lot of things I do for myself personally. To be more in depth with it, I would have to actually sit with the individual and show them how it's done. So I'm always about that as well. Supplements are very important because like you said, you can't get everything from food and you have to take supplements to back up the food that you are eating and getting something from. So yeah.
Absolutely. I agree. I think we're both super into supplements, but it's exactly like what you just said, is that there isn't one supplement that you have to take where you're like, everyone should take vitamin D, I think. But and vitamin C and zinc right now. Like those are like the top three that I think everyone needs to be taking for immunity. But it does depend on the person. Everyone has different deficiencies. We all have different diets. And it depends on where you're getting your food from. So if anyone wants to do a nutrition consultation, we are open to that. So make sure to send us a message and we'd be more than happy to talk to you about your nutrition. I guess supplements then would be my second tip for people, is that make sure you're stepping up. Like, I know some people are like, oh, I get all my nutrition from food. The way that food is processed nowadays is not the same way that it used to be processed. And a lot of it is being stripped of its nutrients. So you do need to be taking a supplement, especially if you're vegan or vegetarian. There's a lot of B vitamins that you're lacking, and Bs are very, very important for immunity and reduce inflammation in your body.
And stress levels,
which is exactly like what you said, Fletch, is like stress. Yeah. And that's my third tip, is that make sure that you are moving during this time and you're exercising and you have a structured plan in your day every single day where you're doing at least 30 minutes of movement. And if you don't, you need to start creating that. Find out like what makes you excited, what jacks you up. Do you like to do Pilates? Do you like to dance? Do you like to strength train? Like
yoga,
What do you like to do exactly?
Whatever it is you can find that you like to do and keeps you engaged the whole time, which is
absolutely great. But that being said, I mean, a lot of people don't really like strength training, but you still need to do it because muscle supports your bone structure, it increases your metabolism, it helps your body burn energy, it prevents
bone density as well.
Yeah,
as we're getting older, so that's very important as well for everything.
Exactly.
Clients out there, and also for other people to know.
Absolutely. Every single person should be strength training, whether yes. you're a runner or a yogi or a triathlete or a dancer or whatever, like you still need to build muscle. See any professional athlete, they're also strength training. Even Tiger Woods.
He strength trains like a beast, actually, but that's a different story.
I love it. My bonus tip, though, is accountability. So a lot of times when you're starting a new habit, it's easy to get off track. It's easy to get disappointed. It's easy to not see results and to also become really overwhelmed by so much information that's out there. So I'd say that make sure you have accountability, whether it's with someone like you and I, who is a professional in this industry, who studied this for years, or a friend who's like, come on, let's go for a run, John, you know, but you need to have accountability, and this is the time to do it.
I think this is also the time, most importantly, for everyone to learn how to keep themselves accountable. Without, you know, because we rely on so many outside things, or we have been relying on so many outside sources for everything. And now we're forced to sit with just ourselves and have to rely on ourselves and learn what that really means. And I don't think a lot of people understand that. Even me, I'm learning more about myself because of the time. And I'm learning to like, wow, you know what? I need to really hold myself accountable for my own self. As opposed to like hearing, because it's easy to be lax about how you keep yourself in integrity or with your own discipline to do things or to obtain things or to finish things, right? It's easy to have someone else come and say, hey, you have to get this done. You have to get this done. Always someone in your ear. But what it becomes even more proficient and better for you if you are able to develop, in which all of us have the capabilities and know-how to make sure that we hold our own selves accountable. That's the most important thing here I think we should take with that, is just learning how to hold ourselves accountable and creating that type of environment for ourselves, because behind that becomes our self-discipline and execution behind those things to get things accomplished and our goals seen in reality. So I think that's really important. So it's good to have an external source, like a guru, teacher, rabbi, whatever, personal trainer, wellness coach, and so forth. But the ultimate person that can really push and motivate you, that will always be by your side, no matter where you go, who you're with, and so forth, will always be you first. And so if you learn how to establish that accountability within yourself, within deep in your will and your drive, and understand that and accept that, there's nothing wrong with that, and be with that essence, you will see a major change in everything that's happening with your life and everything that you touch. So, I really believe in that being very important. So.
I love that. I mean, coming from someone who was a Marine for 8 years, like discipline is, and a Virgo.
Yeah. I know, right? It's like, whoa, that's like 2 months a row. That's a lot, right, man.
But you're so like funny and goofy. But no, you know what? What is a good tip that you would give our people to tell them, like, how do you develop discipline? Because that's something that I think everyone struggles with. I struggle with that like every day.
I think the simplest way to start with developing some sort of discipline is just make realistic short-term goals for yourself. Like, I'm going to wake up this time every day and I'm going to do 5 push-ups when I wake up. Or I'm going to make sure when I wake up, I give myself at least a minute to 5 minutes. I'm making it very simple for people to actually do this, but you can go as long as you want, do whatever you want with it. But I'm going to wake up and do a walk. I'm going to wake up or I'm going to make sure that every day at this time, or that I meditate, or that I pray. And that's you know, without any exception, at least 5 or 10 minutes, or to a half hour, however long you need one, 30 seconds, whatever it takes. Or I'm going to make it a discipline to make sure that I'm more aware of how I'm standing or how I'm breathing. There's little things that you can kind of hone in on that you know that you can hold yourself accountable for before you start adding all the big stuff, right? So if you can just get up and do, like, I'm going to get up every morning for the next 2 weeks, I'm going to do a set of 20 push-ups and a set of 20 sit-ups every single day, and that's it. And that's, you know what, that's more than enough. If you're doing it every day, trust me, it all adds up. And then, okay, next morning, and then next, after that 2 weeks, you can start adding different things to the 2 weeks. Every 2 weeks, you add this, you add that. You know, I'm gonna make a habit out of, like, instead of drinking coffee, 2 cups of coffee, I'm gonna have 1 cup of coffee, and I'm gonna have a cup of tea next time. And that's creating new habits and developing discipline and holding yourself accountable, right? And that way you can see yourself accomplishing small goals. And yeah, when you start to see those things happen, I call it, you know, short-term goals accomplished equals a lifetime of dreams come true. So if you're following in those goals and you accomplish those short-term goals, then your dreams are inevitable. They're going to definitely show up, as long because that means you're on the path of getting to where you want to be with that. So that's how it works.
Love that.
That's how I would recommend people to start.
I love that. You know, it actually takes 21 days to build a habit. So make sure that you guys are really consistent with that. I also say, to go even deeper into that, like, not just saying, okay, I'm gonna wake up and do 5 push-ups and like 10 squats or whatever. Why are you doing it? Because
why is powerful.
Doing something without knowing why you're doing it is, you're not gonna stick to it. Like, right. I'm gonna go to the store right now and get toilet paper and go stock up on canned goods, because if I don't, I might not be able to get that stuff. So I know exactly why I'm going, because I'm afraid that if I don't do it, I'm going to have ramifications of not being able to have toilet paper and not being able to eat, right?
No.
Just like when people
toilet paper is no fun.
I know. Or just when people are like, oh, I can't afford to get training, or I can't afford to eat healthy, and then all of a sudden someone they love is in the hospital and they have thousands of dollars worth of medical bills, and they figure out how to afford to pay for those medical bills. So find your why, like, find what jacks you up, what's going to wake you up in the morning, and what you truly want, and create a vision for yourself of who you want to be, like, in the next 6 months. Like, what do you look like? What do you feel like? Like, who are you around? What kind of energy are you putting into the world, right? Yeah. So then you have to start working backwards and be like, this is who I want to be. Well, what are the habits that I need to start taking on in order to be this person that I want?
Exactly. Very cool information. That's exactly awesome. I love it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do it myself, actually.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do some vision.
Yo, Alie, I'm gonna have to take that for myself, man. That's
We all need to do that. I think that's the most important thing I found with all of my clients, and which is why I love you too, is, like, we're both very spiritual people. Like, we don't, cool, if you get abs, awesome, but the biggest thing is, like, how do you want your life to change? How do you want to wake up? Do you want to be able to lift your kids up in the morning? Do you want to have more energy? Do you want to, I don't know, like, what do you really want?
Yeah.
And once you know that, sticking to diet and all this other stuff is easy.
It's easy, man.
Kind
of. That's awesome. I think that's our time right now, actually.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we got to log off. But any last words of wisdom?
Yes. Stay alive, man. Stay alive.
Let's have our freaking out.
Just don't stay alive like I'm alive, but stay alive. Like, live your life, man. Stay alive.
Live your life.
Right? That's what's up.
All right, too much. I love this. Let's make this a thing. Okay.
All right, guys.
Thank you, Fletch. Thank you so much for tuning in and giving us your amazing expertise, like over 20 years of this, right? Like, you've been doing this forever.
Like 24 or 5 years now. Like,
no big
yeah,
deal.
Yeah, I'm getting there, man.
Just
I'm talking about my
age. Of a lifetime, guys. No problem.
So I'm just getting started. Just
yeah.
getting started.
Let's do it. So if you guys have any other questions, please make sure to follow us on social media. You can find me at Alie V Health on Instagram, AlieVHealth, and also on Facebook, Alie Valerio, AlieValerio. Fletch, how can they find you on social?
Oh, you guys can find me on social at Instagram at Trainer Fletch, TRAINER Fletch, FLETCH, all teachers as well, HC Fletcher on Facebook. So you can catch me on both platforms there, but mostly on Instagram for sure. And at Community Wellness, if you guys are willing to get in contact with us, we're there.
Yeah, definitely. Go to KimiaWellness.com, KimiaWellness.com, and also find us on Facebook and Instagram. All right, let's have an amazing day. Stay well. Be cool.
Stay well. Be well.
Stay in love.
Stay in love, man.
All right, thanks, Fletch. You freaking rock. Let's have an amazing day.
You too. Be well.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.